Just Nyren here. So this is War Leaders Clash of Nations, a strategy game much like Medieval Total War Kingdoms. It was inspired by Medieval 2, I believe. It was released in 2008. Okay, so it's very much like Medieval 2, but set in World War 2. And it was released unfinished, I believe. That's why all the minor nations of the world map have the same boring units. They are like rebels. Okay, so I have already uploaded two episodes previously. The first episode was about 2.5 hours long, and I believe 2 hours 47 minutes or something, or 49 minutes, and the second episode was 1 hour 24 minutes. Okay, so I played with reduced settings in the first episode, so I didn't have maximum graphics on. And in the second episode I used maximum graphics, so they were on, but I didn't have huge unit size because it would lag. So my cooler for the computer, my computer's cooler was broken. It was almost about to stop working. That's why it lagged so much in battle when there were explosions and such. So I have gotten a new cooler in the middle of March, I believe, or March 18 or something. So I played this game back then, the first day after I got the computer, but I didn't record. So you can say I play tested, and now the game won't lag when explosions happen and such. So you can use the planes and bomb areas without the screen shaking or lagging. But if I used huge settings, it would still lag. So I can't use huge settings. We are using large settings, but it's good enough. When we have many armies present on the same battlefield, it will still be huge. Okay, so we are continuing the German campaign. So I used some cheats in order to get more armies at the start, because in my opinion, Germany was ready for war at the start of the war on September, I believe. Was it September 1st, 1939, or was it September 9? I don't remember. But anyway, so yeah, we had a lot of armies. So I spent that day conquering the rest of the rebels that we should have conquered in the early years of the war. Instead of killing off France, I decided to take the areas of Norway, Denmark, Sweden. Of course we shouldn't have Sweden, but because they are rebels anyway, we took it that too. Okay, and then we took the Balkans, and I believe Greece. But it would seem that the British have taken this ISIL. Cyprus, I believe. Okay, we also have an arm here representing Rommel that has landed in Italian held territory. So we have Italian planes here and an army of Germans. Okay, unfortunately, Italy attacked France and took most of France, and because we didn't want Italy to hold it, we had to take some areas too. Okay, so France is defeated in Europe. We are in the year 1941, 5th September 1941, and so the Soviet Union have declared war on us. They took one area, this area, I believe it's Romania. So we have lost Romania to the Soviet Union, and we have taken all the rebel areas that we should own by this point, and landed in Africa. And because I wanted to continue play the Let's Play when all the rebels were defeated, so we can just fight the other factions. But unfortunately, Italy killed off France. So I believe France still has a presence in Africa, but not in Europe. Okay, in this campaign, the historically accurate campaign, factions won't declare war until the historical dates. I believe the Americans are still not in the war. I believe they will enter the war on 7 December 1941. And we are on 5th September 1941. Japan hasn't entered the war either. But Italy entered the war and Soviets entered the war. And because France is defeated in the East, we are now to face the Soviet Union. Italy can't attack us and we can't attack Italy because we are allied, and in the historical accurate campaign it's not possible to betray your allies, unlike in the other campaigns. So Britain still holds Britain, and they have terrorized this continent. The problem with this game is that if, for example, Britain takes, let's say, Belgium or Holland, then if we move an arm here, then they might move here, and then we move there, they might move to a different area, so it will become like a chase, where you chase the army all over the place. That's one of the bad things about the campaign in this game, that they can move their troops from the area when we move in. In Medieval 2, for example, if you attack a region, then that faction, if they are in a settlement, can't move because it's under siege. But in this game, if they have an army here, then they can move out and we move in. So we will have to chase them down all over the place. That's very annoying. So it's a little weird sometimes, but and it's annoying to chase the army around. We managed to hunt down and defeat the last British army that landed in Europe and moved all over the place. I chased them first in Germany and then into France and then into Italy. Very annoying. Anyway, let's continue. I want to play some battles with the new cooler to see how much better it will be now in terms of lagging and such. Okay. Hopefully it won't lag at all. Okay, so the Soviet Union have taken Romania. Of course we need to take it back. We can't move troops from the border areas, then they might attack with other armies. Maybe we'll let the Soviets invade. So we have some agents here already. Let's move that one further into the Soviet Union. We'll move agents here. So we have some armies. Here we have some tanks and artillery. Okay. Of course I prefer having the heavy stuff in the army. So we'll move out something else. Probably move out. Well, we move out one mortar. We'll add artillery. Okay. Let's exit that guy. The question is, so the Soviet Union have a fleet here too. How will we strike there? If we attack here, they might attack. The problem is, if I move here, then they might actually attack this area, and we have no army there. Are we at war? We are in truce currently. Yes, we managed to make a truce with the Soviet Union. Okay. Let's move our armies. We can't leave these shores because the British might send an army here then. Then we'll have to chase them again like we did. Okay, but we have a truce right now with the Soviet Union. Do we have any airfields here? Building detail cannon factory. Medium vehicle factory. Light vehicle factory. Barracks for regular troops, okay. No, I don't think we have any airfields there. Let's see. The armies here too. Let's move that agent. Let's Let's move this guy down into, I believe, Czechoslovakia. Is it Slovakia, actually? Okay. This army could move into Hungary. This one could move here into the protectorate of Bourbon and Marin. You don't really need armies on the border with it. Let's move some troops into Yugoslavia too. I believe this is Yugoslavia. Okay, so I have some armies on this border. Well, we leave them. What about Africa? I think we could attack the French there. We only have trucks, some older tanks, and infantry. Some artillery too, and mortars. Machine gunners. I think they have the upper hand. But in this area, we actually have backup of our Italian Air Force. Okay, I mean our allies' Italian Air Force. Here I have a fleet. So yeah, I did use some sheets to make our fleet bigger because we needed transport, I believe. Move troops to Norway and to to Africa and to Cyprus. Okay. So let's just end the turn. We will use the money sheet. I suck in this game when it comes to that stuff anyway. I don't remember the code. Fuck, I've forgotten how to do the codes. I will be back soon, alright, see ya. Alright, I'm back. So, for some reason the cheat code didn't work. I'm clicking the right button, but nothing happens. Now it happened. Alright, so my keyboard is really old. It's the same keyboard in use by my computer, by the family computer back in 2002. You see, the USB slots of the computer stopped to work for a while. So I had to use a different connection. And the old keyboard from 2002 had a very different cable. It's not a USB cable, but a different, like, one. Okay, and it worked, but for some reason certain buttons have stopped to not react and such. I have to push them extra hard or such from time to time. It started to have problems. Okay, so we're back in War Leaders Clash of Nations. So we weren't attacked, and yeah, I don't know if we will let them attack or if we I think we will just have to attack. No fun if we are not really playing it like it's supposed to. And yeah, we will just suicide our armies. will invade the Soviet Union. I mean, they invaded, but we made a truce with them. Truce till September. Let's move. At high historical accuracy, you can't attack a nation that didn't participate in World War II yet. 12th September, they are supposed to be at war with us. And I believe we're fighting in Romania. But for some reason, when loading the save game, they are now in truce again and we can't attack. Alright. Yes, we will have to exit this campaign. But we can fight a battle against the French. Let's just suicide against them. We are attacking a nation, that's fine. That's the wrong army. Let's move that one back. Actually, we can't let that participate too. We can't attack the Italians, and the French in Europe are defeated. We can't attack the Soviets. Okay. The only ones we can attack are the British and the French. So France is holding these areas. Let's just fight the battle of... I don't know what this area is named. Anyway, let's fight the battle of, I believe it's Tunisia, maybe. Okay. So we have no air force this time, which sucks. We might be defeated, but they do not have an air force either. We have the upper hand. We have 10,601 infantry and they have 31,601. They have the upper hand in infantry. We have 2,150 tanks and they have 459 tanks. Okay. I'm surprised we didn't have any. Okay. I mean, artillery there. Maybe it's only visible after the battle. If it's natural to kill, how come men have to go into training to learn how? You want bees. Battle tip. Artillery is very effective against infantry in open fields. Okay. French troops are attacked by German army. So we have deactivated the voices and sounds because they are all in English and very annoying to hear. So they have a city here. Okay, but we started close to the city. Let's group everyone into group one. Okay. So we can zoom out like this. Have a good overview. When we click space, we can also check everyone. Then we do this. Okay, so this is an African town or city. Started close to it. There seem to be no supply depots here. I believe we are playing with oil in battles, but not on the map. Okay. So we are attacking, we will have to advance, but they will move their troops too. So they have some tanks here. They have this tank. Char Lager doesn't look like the best tank. We have an artillery piece, some armored cars, better than other cars, and they have more artillery. I believe their artillery is superior too, more heavy with longer distance. They have some artillery trucks, I mean anti-aircraft trucks. And they have some more tanks. This tank actually looked quite good. Better than our Panzer I OSFB. And Panzer I OSF A, I believe. Okay, so they have better tanks than we have. Look at our army. See that we have these tanks with machine gun turrets. Not the best, the worst tank actually in the army. And yeah, we have the wrong one. Then we have we have the one with the machine gun, no real tank. We have some trucks for supplies and oil. We have some armored cars, machine guns, some artillery. Yeah, our tanks are not as good as theirs. This battle. Do we have any areas where we can supply the troops? Area with a banner. I don't think so. This battlefield was very small. Okay. Start the battle. And believe it's been a while since I played the game, so of course I don't remember exactly how I did things. Annoying. Fuck, I moved the troops. Okay. Problem is that I think the UI looks different now. It's supposed to be some buttons where I can move the UI back. Ah, they are hidden behind these. I believe the recording problem used to be here at the upper corner, but now it's down here, which is problematic. Because the buttons are here. Let's see. Okay. Now I found the button. Okay, so we'll click on aggressive mode and attack formation. And we'll attack their army. Graphics are on again, so you can see far into the distance. We have all the effects on, and unlike before, I hope that there won't be any lag when there are explosions. We're moving through the African city or town. I like how the game looks in battle. The graphics look like something from 2009, I believe. Like Empire of the War. The game plays more like Medieval 2, which is good. There are explosions all around us. You started this to see how battle will play with a new cooler back before. afraid we do not have any planes. Looking good, I think. As you can see, we have explosions. We are in the zoomed in view and no lag. Much better than before. We couldn't play in this view when we had two huge forces fighting. It would lag a lot. We also are not using... I managed to remove the lag by playing on slow motion. But now we can play without slow motion and it still won't lag. Like this. Okay, and then we can actually see things in this view too. The sound is a little too high. We'll probably have to lower it so people can hear what I'm saying. Quite a few tanks. We are going to play this game without any cheating and with all the resources, etc. Then I will need to take the time to watch all the tutorial videos, and also I will need to play on easy difficulty because I am not good at playing this game without cheats. Okay. ground firing while the tanks are moving in close. General is back in the town, same with the engineers and the trucks. And I believe these guys are the medics. Okay. They've taken out most of all of our tanks. Still have an artillery. I really feel like that good today. It's like I am not really... I probably need to take a pause and go and eat and such. Maybe I will be more... should I say... less tired. It's like I am not up to the task of speaking and playing. Okay. The artillery is moving forward. All the tanks seem to have been destroyed. We still have machine gunners and mortars. And some machine gun cars, mechanized cars are moving forward too. So this game lacked the BMW motorcycles. Otherwise they have a proper army for Germany. Yeah, it sucks that they do not have the BMP motorcycles. Okay. They were very iconic. So we have taken out some of the French artillery and trucks too. Yeah, I have no problem with the graphics. I think they are good. It's a shame that the HUD settings lag. It's a big difference between huge and large. I believe huge has to use by a lot. And there are tanks everywhere. A big snake of tanks. Then you have an army full of tanks. Oh, here's a supply depot next to the French. As they were defending, we have to take it. I see. Okay. Move forward and take that supply depot. So can we do like this? Quite a few infantry troops there. Let's pause the game. It's impossible to click on them otherwise. Okay, so we can see things from our perspective here. Now we will see it from the perspective of the French. They are taking out some of our mortars that move too close. container and have to put both oil and ammunition in back. Killer advantage in the battle. You've taken the supply depot area, so now I believe that we are being resupplied. Even the trucks are arriving here, because we clicked on the entire army to move here. They've lost me resupplied. That artillery is getting new ammunition. Mortar is firing. Flag is changed to the flag of Germany. Oh, the shooting stopped. They might be dead. These guys are still in the city, okay. Okay. So we have a map here, of course. The artillery is being resupplied, the mortars too. They are artillery too, but kind of worse artillery. Oh, they have an aircraft truck here. They believe all their infantry has been destroyed. Yeah, all the French infantry. Okay. Then we will attack their the aircraft truck. It can be used as artillery too. French. Can't zoom in more than this. Clicking on the vehicles. Oh, and it was destroyed. Minor victory. Okay, you won the battle. Yeah, it worked much better. No lag, even when we played on normal speed. In one of the earlier battles, I had to use slow motion to prevent it from lagging. And I couldn't play zoomed in. I had to use the I believe the Pickler view. Okay. Battle statistics. So we lost 10,321 men out of 10,601 men. So we lost almost all the infantry. They lost all their infantry, 31,601 men. We lost 1,000 tanks out of 1,000 tanks. We lost all the tanks. They lost their tanks too. They had 28 out of they lost 28 of the 28. Then we had 124. We had 500 artillery pieces, and we lost 124. They lost all their 159 or 158 artillery pieces, and then we had 150, I believe, anti-air artillery, and they we lost 18. And they lost all 110 artillery, I believe. Okay, and then they had 127 armored trucks, and they lost all of them, and we had 100 armored trucks, and we lost 75 out of 100. Okay. So minor victory there, we conquered Tunis, I believe. We declared war on France, out of money again. Okay, so we took this area. Algeria, actually. Maybe Tunis is the capital. I don't know. Or maybe this is Tunis. I don't know. Okay. So we conquered Algeria from France. Here we have rebels. Or a minor faction. Spain. Spain is holding that area. France is holding this area too, but they have no troops there. It's time to just move down, take that area too. I have no troops here as well. So we can simply move troops. Okay. We'll do this then. Tech. This area is held by France as well. So the French faction is already counted as defeated, so they won't make any moves, but because Charles de Gaulle is dead, but they will defend if we attack their areas, but they do not have any troops in these areas, so we can just move down, I believe. Okay, let's end the turn. We'll see if they have any troops. Oh, so in the ocean we will face the British Navy. They are attacking our Navy outside of Libya, I believe. So they have two of these, we have two of the other types of ships. I believe they have better ships, they might be in. Ah, we had the upper hand in this battle. I might have given Germany some battle ships. Yeah. So they wouldn't sink my fleet when I move troops to Africa. We won the battle. Okay, conquest of territories. Your nation has conquered Morocco, your nation has conquered Libya, your nation has conquered East Africa. Yeah, they had no troops here. However, Britain is not defeated. We have to do this. Seems Britain has no army here, so we'll conquer this area. From Britain. No arm here either. Let's move into both of those areas. Move that arm into that area. one unit moving in there. This is France. Just move one unit out of here. Move this into the French area there. No, actually we'll move into major victory there in the ocean. Okay, we have a lot of troops inside of Libya. We conquered some new areas. Conquered Sierra Leone and all the Gold Coast. This is Sierra Leone and this is the Gold Coast. Can't attack the areas where we have enemy armies. Liberia. Okay. United Kingdom. That's an area that we want. Just move this army there. This unit actually is not really an army. Let's move on a unit into Egypt as well. One here. Don't know what that region is named. Could also move a unit into this area. Then we need to move further down, so we'll move more than one unit there. Maybe the general can move as well. Okay, end turn. Ah, the British move some troops into Egypt. We'll fight the battle at sea, major victory again. Here they had superiority, we only had some infantry and they have tanks. I believe we will out-resolve that when we lost. Another one out to resolve. What do they want? Oil. No tanks. Um, they are holding Egypt and this area. He failed to take them because they had armies there. Here we have an army, a Belgian army. That's United Kingdom. I believe we can't take any more areas now. We just have one unit. We've taken all of this. Okay. Let's combine these troops then. So an armored car and then an artillery unit. Okay, in the town. I think they are attacking Libya now. See, 139 mechanized units, they have 130, then they have 54 infantry. I believe we will fight this battle. They we also have a backup from our navy. We will fight this battle in the battlefield. Or on the battlefield. Okay. German forces are attacked by British troops. Okay, so we do not have a large force. We have some trucks, Opel Blitz supply trucks. We have the general in the Kubel wagon. This is the general. Then we have this transport car for the general. We have some engineers, mortars, an armored car. Yeah, not much of an army actually. Okay. Pretty bad actually. No real infantry. So we are defending. We will defend somewhere. If there is any supply area where we can defend. Nope. If that's the case, we will move into the city. Oh, actually, we have a supply depot. This is the same area, probably. Or at least the same battlefield that we played last time. Need to protect supply depot. The enemy started too close to it. Maybe they will get there first. Okay, we have the ships over there. It's supposed to gain. They are kind of outside of the area. We can zoom in on them like this. These are the German ships. Okay. So when they stop moving, we will use the ships against them. I believe they will move soon. Yeah, they will move. Be a fight here. Just need them to stop so we can click on them. naval artillery arrive. Firing at the mortar guy, and the mortar guy is firing back, but they killed him. We have no more infantry, they've killed the other guy too, the general. We have some trucks. We could win if we could fire the naval guns again, but I think they will win because they will kill the trucks. They have no weapons, and then we have no land infantry units left. Unless we can somehow retreat. Oh, we had the Kubel wagon too. It will also retreat. I don't know where the enemy is. Treat and we need to know where the here we have enemy car. Machine gun car. Not the best armored truck or car I've seen. We also have a unit here. So they separated too much from each other. Speed up, we have the maximum speed on. We can't use the naval guns currently. We are firing the naval guns now. Got that and the air artillery. We have this one still remaining. So we have a timer too going down, 21 minutes until someone wins or loses. they have a long cooldown, the naval artillery support. They take their sweet time before you can use them again. So, you should be in the battle now. Minor victory. Okay, we won the Battle of Libya. Our general's death. Our hero's death.
With great sadness, the death of one of our nation's most outstanding heroes has been announced today. His feats, known nationwide, thanks to the journalistic coverage which always accompanied his efforts, will stand as a permanent example for our youth and our brave soldiers at the battlefront. We invite all our troops and citizens to emulate his courage and tenacity when confronting the enemy. His exemplary bravery and serenity in the most dangerous of situations, along with his ability to stir up his fellow soldiers in battle, must never be forgotten in order for our nation to obtain the glory encapsulated by our deceased hero.
All right. Northern Africa, with the exception of Egypt. Move our fleet towards the British fleet there. Sucks, I can't attack the Soviets. Ah, now we can attack, finally. Don't care if we are in truce with the Soviet Union, we will attack. Okay. Oh, we don't have the reach to go that far. See, that sucked. This area, probably part of Poland, and we'll also attack Ukraine. Move this army down into Romania. Ah, so they are not holding Romania, then they are holding Bulgaria, probably. Okay, we'll move an army there. We'll attack there as well. So we are attacking 1, 2, 3, 4 areas of the Soviet Union. It's not good to attack in too many places at once. Maybe we should not attack there. We will attack in 3 areas. Okay, enter. if we are attacked in Africa now, we will just auto-resolve. So ship battles ended in a heroic victory. Bulgaria, so they have 864 planes, tanks I mean, and we have 1300 tanks. And we have about the same in infantry, the same number in infantry. They have 20,082 and we have 21,100. Let's fight this battle too. No planes, only infantry and tanks. So the Soviet Union took Bulgaria from us when I played without recording against the rebels. Okay, German forces attack Soviet army. Let's group everyone. We need to find a supply depot area. If there are any. Here we have one. They seem to be holding it. Okay, aggressive mode on. And attack formation. Let's go for their supply depot. So, we have started to move. Entire army is moving. Normal speed is on. Here we can see the troops, the tanks moving forward. Pause the game, it's impossible to click on the units unless they are selected. Okay, need a better view than that. Usually the machine gunners are behind everything else, so we don't want them selected. We want the rifleman selected, but we want a rifleman that is close to the tanks. Or the panzers, as they're called in German. Okay, here we can see some tanks. Here too. This one was better. Okay, unpause the game. Attack the supply depot held by the Soviet Union. This seems to be the same battlefield that we fought in before. Similar house and such. I like how they jump over fences and such. It's looking good. There's some tanks over there. Panzers. Thank you. against tanks in this game. They have grenades to take out tanks. Probably our infantry. We have some artillery, mortars, medics and engineers back behind everyone else. Here we have a infantry guy. This is the battle to take back Bulgaria from the Soviet Union. They steamrolled our weak garrisons, they have only had infantry. We'll restart this campaign and play like it's supposed to be played without cheating, but I will play in an easy difficulty. Minor victory, good job. So Bulgaria was reconquered from the Soviet Union. The USSR, United Soviet Socialist Republic. So we have at least two more battles to fight against the Soviet Union. We are invading. We lost almost all our infantry. We lost 20,122 men out of 21,100 men. They lost all their 20,002 men. They lost all their tanks, all their artillery, and all their armored cars. We lost 157 artillery pieces out of 400, and 600 tanks out of 600 tanks. We lost all the tanks. Okay. We only had the worst ones. Okay, we are attacking Polesien, a part of Poland held by the Soviet Union. Okay, so we have 10,800 men, they have 60,500, we have 1,795 tanks, they have 900 tanks, that's why we are leading, we have the upper hand in tanks, and they have in infantry. Okay, let's fight the battle on the battlefield. Most powerful weapon on earth is the human soul on fire. Marshal Ferdinand Foch. German army attacks Soviet troops. Or attacks Soviet troops. Okay. Group everyone into one group. Aggressive mode on. We are attacking this time, so they should be holding the supply depot. We are attacking on three fronts. See, they have lots of infantry. They look like this, the Soviet infantry. They had only ordinary infantry. Oh, they had some medics too, female medics. Otherwise, just infantry with rifles, the worst infantry type. They have some armored cars. They look worse than ours, way worse. Their little guns. Yeah, they are way worse. They have some supply depots, and some artillery. Okay. Soviet army, no real tank, forced on artillery and trucks. Now, is there any area where there is a supply depot? Here there is a supply depot. There is a... I believe you're starting over here. Okay. I'd like to take that supply depot area. Okay. Start the battle. We have no planes in this battle either. But there are some buildings. Medics and machine gunners are moving. Get quite the force of panzers this time. Not only the weakest types. Maybe we have some of the OSFB too. Second type. Fighting has started. a lot of the men of the battlefields will be the same. They still have the upper hand in mechanized units, but they had the upper hand in infantry by far. The infantry are key in this game. They might be, because of the only thing better than many infantry is probably planes. That's because the infantry drops grenades and it can easily take out tanks. Ground is shaking because of all the explosions. Probably the artillery. at least far from over. They took out the infantry guy there and the tank. Leading the statistics. Game so you can see anything. Let's see here. The enemy only have very few units left. So we still have quite a few artillery pieces and tanks remaining. We still have tanks. I see. They couldn't win with just infantry. Still, infantry is quite good against tanks. They have the grenades, as I said. They're not worthless. But you can't win with a superiority in infantry against superiority in tanks and artillery. Okay. They still have a few guys remaining, I believe, but they are in the back. Seem to be artillery. Mortars, actually. These are the Soviet mortars. It's a little annoying with all the ground shaking. Okay, we can probably pause the game, speed it up. Didn't get past. Anyway, now we have normal speed on. Yeah, the ground shaking, earth shaking is real annoying. Your victory. So none of the battles had planes. That's a little boring. I wanted to see the planes in action with the new cooler. Okay, we won again. We lost half of the infantry. 43 out of 600 artillery pieces, 642 out of 795 tanks, and most of the tanks. We lost all our cars, 100 out of 100. The final battle. They have 500 planes. I hope they are not bombers. We have 50,601 infantry. They have zero infantry. We have 1,000 tanks. They have zero tanks. They have one ship and 500 planes. That's interesting. Ukraine, then we should win. I don't think they can win with just planes and ships. Soviet army is attacked by German troops. Okay. Group them and aggressive mode on. Okay, let's see if they have any supply depots we can take. So this is the Battle of Ukraine. Here we have a supply depot held by the Soviet Union. Let's move there, start the battle and move there. Heroic victory immediately. They had no ground troops, that's why we won. If they had out-resolved, they could have won, probably. Alright. They can't win with just planes and ships. So the ships are still in at sea. And the planes, they lost all of those planes. Okay. Or maybe not. Maybe they just moved to a different area. We pretty much took Ukraine without any real trouble. Maybe the planes moved to the Moscow area. Okay. infiltrated into the Soviet Union. We can attack this area now. Planes are stuck here in East Prussia, I believe. Ostpreussen, yeah, that's East Prussia. Okay, and we can move this. So this is different area. Let's move an army there. Actually, we have a general. We can move him into the army. Move the army. Then move this unit there. Move an army into Ukraine. Well, this army can take the area. I believe if we move out of Ukraine with that army, they might attack from Moscow. And it sucks we don't have planes. So we're attacking this area and this area. Let this army stand there. Move this army into Ukraine as well. Oh, Soviet has taken Turkey. We will move into Turkey with an army. This army can let me see. We'll move there from Yugoslavia. Okay, so we are attacking Turkey and the other two areas here. And not moving from Ukraine right now. Here we have Britain. This is the Soviet Union. Okay, so we are moving into Turkey. Okay, end turn. Ah, they didn't even fight back. We got these areas. We got Leningrad without any resistance. And we got Belarus. Okay, and we got Turkey. So we're pretty big now. Okay. Now we have a border with the British too. So we can't move this army, I believe. Otherwise, I would have moved them here. Then the British might take Turkey. Start attacking here. Actually, we could probably. No, they have ships here, the British. So we could send an army now. Oh, we have two areas here. Let's move in with this army to this area. Attack the Soviet capital area with an army. Two armies can move there. This army can move into this area. Actually, move all three into the Soviet capital area. And in Turkey, let's move up there. I don't really care about Turkey that much. This army can move into Turkey too. Okay, and turn. Alright, they have air superiority, they have 500 planes. We have infantry superiority, we have 57,980 infantry, and they have 20,000. Then we have 3,610 tanks, they have 900 tanks. We have tank superiority too. We'll fight that battle in the battle, on the battlefield. Greatness is a road leading towards the unknown, Charles de Gaulle. Oh, it's a capital area. It will lag probably because of all the buildings. Soviet troops are attacked by German forces. I forgot that the capitals have their own huge cities. And that it will probably lag a lot because of it. Let's group this arm into one group. Okay, that's not good. So the enemy army is over here. Okay, but aggressive stance and attack formation. Start the battle. Let's fast forward their movement. They will start to move their infantry and trucks, artillery and so on. They have a supply depot here. This is Moskva. Just wait until they have moved. Wonder what types of planes they do have. So we had no planes in the army, but we had three huge armies attacking. So three armies without air support. Three early period, early war armies. Okay. Time, I believe, to move. Okay, we can slow down the speed. See it from this view. Looks kind of impressive. We can also place troops inside of these buildings, but yeah, it's kind of laggy because of all the buildings. It was possible to reduce the lag in the capitals by reducing the graphics and distance and such, but it's not worth it, I think. You can't change the settings unless you exit the main menu. So that means you would have to use the worst graphics in ordinary battles too. Yeah, it lags a lot in this view when we are in the capitals. So this is the Soviet capital. Okay, too much lag to be in that view. Even on in this view it lags kinda. If you if you slow down. Maybe it will lag less. Or maybe not. Battle of Moscow. Battle started. You can hear them firing. Maybe some tanks have reached there. Maybe some artillery is shooting, firing. Here we have Soviet 122mm. M3-1s. Some infantry has reached this area. Here we have Soviet artillery and Soviet armored cars too. Cars car is firing on this infantry guy, he will probably die soon. Alright, too much lag in that view. First to get to the supply area. He died. Oh, we can hear the sound of planes now. They've sent in some planes. They think they are fighters. They can't do anything against our ground troops. Only bombers are good against troops. Three full-sized armies. No wonder it lags. Plus the city itself. Okay. That's probably a better tank. A snake here. Troops. I think this is the best. Maybe not. This one is probably the better one. Yeah, I think one of these are better. Slightly bigger. Still not that good. That one looks smaller. goes way too slow. Let's use normal speed. We'll be right back. dead now. You're one on the ground. Too few ground troops. I believe the fighter planes couldn't do anything to aid. Okay, they lost zero of their fighters. Capital conquered.
In a radio communique to the nation, our country's chief military press officer today announced the end of the fierce fighting involving our troops against Soviet forces in Moscow, and that the Russian capital is now under our complete control. Despite the immensity of the USSR and her human and economic resources, the fall of Moscow come as a severe blow to the morale of her armed forces and the population as a whole.
Okay, and other areas fell too. So he conquered North Moscow, Archangel. Without a fight, he conquered this area, Azerbaijan, held by the Soviet Union. In this area, Stalingrad has been conquered too. The Soviet Union is defeated and Stalin has escaped this area. Let's just hunt them. We will move into this area next. USSR. Down here too. Here we have China, Mongolia, USSR. Okay, we'll send another army to this area, this army to this area, then this army will move there. We'll keep one in the Moscow area and turn. Oh, they are counterattacking, trying to take back Moscow. So here they have 200 tanks, we have 736 tanks, they have 10,000 infantry. In the Urals. I believe we'll conquer the Urals. We'll attack in real time. Okay. Group. The one group. So we have winter terrain here. Excuse me. Okay. Stay on the defender, they probably have the supply depot. Wherever it is. Here we have the air force, they have some artillery pieces and some infantry. Not much. Here we have a supply depot area held by the Soviet Union. Let's use aggressive mode and attack formation. Let's attack that area. We had lots of tanks in this battle, panzers. Forward some armored trucks and supply depots as well. supply depot has probably already been conquered. Taken. Did we have a bunker? Two bunkers. Okay, but we don't know if we had any infantry in this moment. Maybe so. Was mostly, or it is mostly an armored army. Yeah, mostly tanks, trucks and such. Some artillery too. No infantry as far as I can see. The supply depot area. Lots of panzers. Enemy is moving. They moved into this village. Some infantry. They're holding some of the buildings. All our troops, with the exception of the artillery, has moved into place. I don't think we need to wait on the artillery. Normal speed is now on. We will attack the city here. All the troops inside of the buildings. Tank force is moving down. What a panzer force. Okay, let's see how this will go. Answers. still have their artillery at the beach. They're moving up here. Let's attack them with the tanks. So I've already killed off the infantry inside of the village. Another supply depot area here. We need to take. Our army got degrouped. Okay, one army grouped there and then move towards this area. Supply depot and kill the final infantry unit of the Soviet Union in the Urals. took the Urals. Okay. Heroic victory. So Moscow is under attack. Soviet Union has attacked Moscow with 50,201 men. We only have 3,994 men there. We also have 1,400 tanks and we have 1,005 tanks. They might win this battle. They have the upper hand. We will fight it. Take out one of our armies. Soviet troops attack German forces. Let's group them. Aggressive mode on. Let's have defensive stance or formation on. We need that supply depot area. Don't know if we are starting close to it or not. Maybe they started there again. Yeah, they did. Even though we have the banner here, the Soviet Union still started at the locations. They will take it immediately. We can't probably place our troops here. Exactly. Alright, then we will not have defensive mode on. We will have aggressive mode on. And, yeah. Attack. All the other armies moved out of the capital area. We only left one army here. And it's far from the strongest one. It has lots of artillery but almost no tanks. Lots of infantry too. Enemy, they have a lot of artillery. Trucks. They have a general as well. We already created it. Like a snake of troops here. Oh, here we have some anti-aircraft. trucks. All their artillery gathered. Our troops are rather slow. We are firing from here. The artillery. We have a general here too. Few of the mortars. artillery and infantry versus artillery. They took out that artillery gun. They have a lot of artillery. Soviet Union is moving forward. Okay, our tank is moving this way. Here we have the general. and our general. And the medics. Another gun over there and that panzer. So the artillery can't do much against the infantry in close range. The panzer should be able to do something. There are too many. Soviet Union is advanced. Still have the tank. Let's pause the game. Air truck, we'll probably take it out. Now we are under fire. So we did take a supply depot area. They almost won the battle on the ground here. No one had planes, so we are losing. They had total numerical superiority here. Let's see. So they will retake Moscow. Wagon. Yep. I believe one can use it to move the general faster. The general is dead. So we managed to take the supply depot area with these two tanks. Okay. No more attack formation. Just use defensive formation then. At least they get new ammunition and oil. They are not enough to hold this area for long. Now they have some defense. That supply depot. Okay. She lost Moscow. Okay, major defeat. We lost most of the infantry, the rest were taken prisoner. I mean, they lost most of the infantry, okay. We lost everyone, actually. We had way fewer infantry troops. Areas, this area, Kazakhstan was conquered. The Urals, as you saw, we fought a battle there. We took this area previously. We have this area too, East Moscow. The British are attacking Libya. We only had 25 tanks. We will have to resolve that when they won. Turkey is under attack by the British too. We had a lot of infantry there. They have 300 tanks. I think we can win that battle. I think we will have to resolve. Major victory. Good. Oh, we managed to conquer even more areas of the Soviet Union. We took Siberia. They have this area too. Siberia is pretty big. Just continue. This one will move there, and then we move this one up there. base, we have 17,822 infantry, they have 16,359 infantry, so we have almost the same number in infantry. We have 1,643 tanks, they have 1,046 tanks. We have superiority in tanks. Should be able to win this. Let's auto-resolve. Heroic victory. No tanks, I won't give you any oil. Okay, new hero. Don't need to see that. Capital conquered, we have already seen it. We conquered Moscow again. Now we can move this army down. This army can move down there. Actually, this army can move up to the east, and this army can move there. Leave an army in Moscow. Another area over here, we took Yakutsk from the Soviet Union. We have one area left. We'll invade here. Here we have Japan. So the British failed to take Turkey. Save, by the way, save current game. Okay, and turn, I just want to kill off the Soviet Union. So Stalin has moved down into British areas. Capitulation! Alright, so we defeated the Soviet Union. So France and the Soviet Union are defeated. I saw that Stalin had fled down into British areas. You can win by capturing the leader or by taking all their territory. If you take all their territory, then it doesn't matter if they have the leader somewhere else. So we took this area. Kamchatka. Okay, let's see. Conquest of territories. Your nation has conquered Kamchatka. Your nation has lost Tunisia. Okay. USSR has been defeated. Okay, so we have won against the Soviet Union. The British have taken this area. And this area now too. So they took Libya and Tunisia. Alright, I think this is it for now. I don't know if I will continue this or start another campaign where I will try to play it as it's intended. But yeah, it was pretty easy to kill off the Soviet Union. And you had like too many armies at start. Okay. See ya.